Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance led by Life Scout Peter Yoro from Boy Scout Troop 133.
Ooh,
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, for liberty and justice for all.
Amen. Thank you.
Thank you. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Welcome to the first Recognizing Trailblazers event celebrating confident and courageous women who shaped DuPage. You may be wondering how this event came to be. Our staff began thinking last fall about how we seldom see a Black History Month and a Women's History Month event joined together. And we felt celebrating both simultaneously celebrated a cross-section of society that was much underappreciated. We approached our foundation board member, Melody Coleman, to assist us in planning this event. And at our first brainstorming session, we discussed what themes to focus on. We ran down a list of our exhibits that we currently had and thought maybe we could find a theme in there. And we came across Together We Win, DuPage in World War II. That exhibit is up and you're welcome to see it after the event. While time separating us from World War II meant it was unlikely to find a woman of color who participated in that war in DuPage County, we did think it was a perfect way to celebrate both Black History Month and Women's History Month by celebrating women veterans of color. Melody began making some connections with local women's club and reaching out to the honor flight. She was put in contact with the VA, and we partnered with the VA program Confident and Courageous, who provided some DuPage County residents who served both in Confident and Courageous, as well as in lived in DuPage County. These four wonderful women are just the beginning of our list of veterans, and we're always looking for more veterans to participate in our oral history initiative, Voices of DuPage. So if you know of veterans, or if you are a veteran yourself and served in the military, we would love to hear your story and report it for future generations. If you're interested, you can contact Zach Bishop, our museum curator, or myself, and we'd be happy to make those arrangements. I'd like to introduce Confident and Courageous, Sonia
Elbow Pivot.
The peer specialist at Edward Hines Jr. VA Hospital, to say a few words on what Confident and Courageous is, how it began, and where she envisions it going in the future.
Mm-hmm. All right, Sonia.
Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon.
Thank you for such a warm and welcoming introduction. To the dignitaries, the honorees, and everyone who has had a part in making this event happen, we sincerely thank you. Recognizing trailblazers, confident and courageous women who shaped DuPage seems like a big pair of shoes to fill. I am sure that every honoree here, including myself, are truly honored and at the same time humbled by this opportunity. To be given this opportunity in honor of Black History Month as well as Women's History Month is like the icing on the cake, or the cool whip with the cherry on top. So I was asked here today to talk about confident and courageous women Empowerment Group, which is a group that started at Hines VA Hospital as a solution for fellow veterans, female veterans, who needed a safe and confidential place to have their own discussions about their own needs. Now to do that, I want to take you a little bit back to my story. So I am a United States Marine. Once a Marine, you're always a Marine. The Air Force, the Army. However, transitioning from military service to civilian life brought with it lots of trials and tribulations. It also brought with it some invisible wounds, and for some of us, some visible wounds that we needed to deal with. We know that VA has always been a male-dominated environment. And so when I came out of the service in 1993, I went to the VA, and everything I needed was shipped out into the community. And I never returned until Hines VA for the next 17 years. And when I returned as a veteran who was homeless with children, needing medical care, and had gone through many, many, many trials and tribulations. I came riding in on public transportation on the bus, and I remember riding through the campus and literally crying, saying to myself, I'm finally home. And it was at Hines VA where I found my strength. And I realized that I still had some fight left. And after doing what I needed to do, mentally, physically, and socially, I said to myself, if I ever got the opportunity to work for the VA, the first thing I'm going to do is to ensure that I gave back and I left no female veteran behind. And I got that opportunity. In 2011, I began working at Hines VA as a vocational specialist. I transferred to Captain James Lovell as a peer specialist and came back in 2015 to Hines as the sole female veteran looking to create women programming. That was my opportunity. I have to ask you, have you ever imagined something that you didn't think was ever possible? I have. Confident and Courageous started as a simple group with maybe 8 women who would get together and again talk about female issues. We talked about parenting and many of the other different hats that women seem to wear. And we found out that women, or no veteran for that matter, actually lived in VA. We actually lived in the communities of our choice. And it was in those communities where we live, work, and play, where we needed to come together as a supportive environment, much like the camaraderie we had while serving in the military, and launch not only a supportive network for our individual goals, but also bring rise to the veteran voice for females in VA. And from that small group, Confident and Courageous became a program, simply because we decided to do life together. And by doing life together, what I mean is, we celebrate together, we support each other in losses, and being the Marines, the soldiers, the air women, Navy the squeal. is that we are, we fight together. We fight together to make sure that everyone knows that females were part of the military and that we held roles that were essential. We advocate for all of the different days, Military Sexual Trauma Day, Domestic Abuse Awareness Day, any other day you can find, you will find confident and courageous utilizing their individual strengths and putting together some programming to make sure women veterans are acknowledged. And then we took our show on the road and began to go out into the community, volunteering, creating book clubs. You name it, if someone in the group can imagine it, there is another woman in Confident and Courageous willing to lead it, and a whole group of us willing to stand behind it and make it happen. Confident and Courageous in September fought to, for the first time in VA history, do something we'd never done before, that was never done before, and not only did we plan, fight for, advocate for, and host our own women's wellness retreat in the community, but we also, from all of our programming and the way we moved, are now currently being looked at in VA to be piloted nationally across VA. So from that one group, and on any given Wednesday, 9 o'clock in the morning and 1 o'clock, at least 18 to 20 women are online planning. But that is not the end of it. Because at that wellness retreat, these women came together and we thought, yeah, we do live in the community. We work in the community, we play in the community. And we realized that not every female veteran actually goes to the VA. So we have a whole slew of female veterans in the community that we need to catch hold of, that we need to bring into our fold to support and to encourage. And so, Melody, when you ask what I envision Confident and Courageous to look like in the future, well, I would tell the women that I work with that I envision a wellness, recovery, empowerment center. Not just for the women veterans, because every female in the community has a skill, has some strength. And regardless of where you are in life, regardless of the trials and tribulations, all you need is a support system and the belief that if you can imagine it, it can be done.
Amen.
For me, Confident and Courageous is proof that your imagination actually can run wild and become so much more than you imagine it to be. I imagine a group of women supporting each other. The women that came along in that group helped me see it was so much more than that. And as we move succinctly, still marching, pick them up and set them down, marching from the waist down, we now see Confident and Courageous Women Empowerment Center is closely within view. As a female veteran and the peer specialist, I am no one important. I'm simply another female veteran who had a lived experience and took my mess and created a message and my test became my testimony that witnessed to the other women in the group that hope is possible, recovery is possible. All you have to do, pick them up, set them down. And so today, I am honored to have some of my fellow confident and courageous women who have been there from the beginning, some who are relatively new, but all of us have been committed to the fight of female veteran issues in VA and in the community. And if you are a women's organization in the community, much like the DuPage County Museum, we are looking to partner with you so that we can reach, teach, support, encourage, and lift as we continue the fight of leave female veteran behind. Across this country. And if I have my way, you will definitely hear it in the White House. See, one thing about being a Marine, being military, we're not afraid of a fight. And in fighting what is going to take, and sisters, my seat is already packed. We're in for the long haul. And if you are supportive of female veterans or veterans anywhere, I want to thank you for your support and thank you for this opportunity. Confident and courageous.
We're going to begins. And while Michelle is doing that, because we do nothing by ourselves, I do want to recognize my husband who collaborated with me on this.
Because they love their country,
They had a family member, in two cases it was their father, that inspired them to join the military, which I think is very admirable for women. Their father inspired them to join. Or they had brothers as well. But the other reason was because they wanted an education. And they knew that if they served their country, when they were done, they would be able to go to school. I think that says a lot. And so, Mary became a nurse. Sonia received a bachelor's, a dual master's. Lynette went on to the OR program, hospital work, and Sonia gave her biography earlier. So at this time, I would like for them to stand so that we can honor them for the service that they have given us and give them back just a little bit of our appreciation.
And we encourage everyone to learn more after today's program, as these clubs have tables in the back of the room that they'd be happy to speak with you. And if the DAR for Kmiecik chapter wanted to stand, so that we can help them. Also today, with us is local author and historian Glennette Tilly Turner. Mrs. Turner is a nationally known author with several books, and she has offered to answer questions and sign books here today at her table after the program. So thank you, Mrs. Turner. Thank you to Peter Diorio, sorry, and the Girl Scouts who helped usher today.
Oh, thank you.
Also, program. It is such an inspiring program, and I'm so happy to have learned about it, even if we hadn't, when we set out on this journey, thought that that's what we're going to come across. It was a perfect partnership for us.
Thank you.
I'd also like to thank our DuPage County Historical Museum Foundation Board. We have some members here today. Melody Coleman, of course, whom we've met. And Philip Buchanan. We also have a couple local and state level legislators and representatives here with us today. And I'd like to thank them for their public service and offer, if they'd like to have a few words, then you're welcome to. So we have Illinois House Representative Costa Howard here today.
Those of us who are in elected positions rarely turn down an opportunity to say thank you to our people. On behalf of the 48th District, on behalf of the state of Illinois, thank you for your service, but more importantly, thank you for never leaving a woman behind.
Yes. We also have DuPage County Board Member Greg Hart here today.
Thank you so much, Michelle, and I'll be brief, but I just want to say how incredibly honored I am to be in the same room as all of our honorees. Let's give them another round of applause. I represent District 3 on the DuPage County Board, which is the southeastern part portion of this county, but as we all know, the county board represents the whole county, and having this institution here in Wheaton, in the center of our county, as well as so many fantastic residents looking around the room, really makes us all realize why we're so proud to be from DuPage County. And personally, as someone who's raising a daughter in this county, I just am so fortunate that they have role models, and she is a role model to look up to in all her degrees. So thank you all so much. And thank you.
Thank you all for joining us today. We do have some tea and light refreshments available by the window. We will be bringing them out shortly. Mrs. Turner, the Naperville Women's Club, and the DAR 14 chapter will all be at their tables if you have any questions or looking. I'm sure they can help you with some membership information if you're interested in joining. They all have fascinating histories. I'm sure they can give you some information on that as well. We, after all, are very much about history here at the museum. And please take time to go through the exhibits. We do have three floors here. We have two Civil War flags here in this room, and then a World War II exhibit and ghost towns of DuPage on the first floor. And then we have our 50-year-old model railroad train set downstairs in the basement. Please enjoy the afternoon mingling and let Zach and I know if you have any questions about the museum. And enjoy your afternoon. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.